just another topic. I know I discussed yesterday with you about Canelo-Ggg. Discuss with you a couple of weeks ago.
Guys don't like the truth, bro. The truth hurts. I know. You can't handle the truth, as Jack Nicholson said in The Few Good Men. Listen, like I said, Canelo did better. It's not like I'm telling you this fight was a wash or anything. I'm just telling you Canelo to win it. This is the truth. What I'm going to tell you.
But no,
if you can't handle the truth, then don't listen to Paulie Malignaggi talk, because you're just going to get the truth, whether you like it or not. And a lot of you don't like the truth when it comes to many subject matters that I've noticed.
But I think a lot of people, on the comments yesterday, we got close to 100,000 views on that clip. A lot of people were saying the term robbery is wrong.
No, it's not wrong. It's not wrong. If it was a draw, it wouldn't have been a robbery. Then if I said a draw is a robbery, then I'd be wrong. You know? No. Canelo winning is a robbery. I'm sorry. Okay? A robbery, in the first fight, a draw was a robbery. In the second fight, Canelo did a little better. A draw wouldn't be a robbery. But Canelo winning is a robbery. I'm sorry, bro. You can't find me 7 rounds the guy won. It's mathematics. You need 7 rounds he has to win this fight. You cannot find me 7 rounds if you're judging by the exact same criteria every round. I'm sorry. You can't do that.
We won't go over it again. You've made it clear.
Yeah, bro. Because, you know, there's just preconceived notions. Now, all of a sudden, because you expected Golovkin to come forward and you expected Canelo to go backwards, now you saw the opposite and it's like, well, you know what? Then, you know, Canelo had to have won. No, he didn't win. Watch the fight, bro. It's still boxing. It's not called come forward. It's not called Mexican style. It's not called bang it out. It's not called knockout. It's called boxing. So when it comes to boxing, Golovkin won the fight. His back was never to the ropes at all. So this whole backing him up thing, it's a bit taken out, a bit exaggerated, because if he got backed up that bit, his back would have been to the ropes. He circled the ring. He boxed well. Canelo fought well, too. It was a well-fought fight, honestly. It was a fight that you enjoy, you know, because both guys really did some things very well, you know. But I think the wrong guy won the fight. That's all I'm saying. And I think a draw would have been really, really nice to see. But ultimately, I do think both guys fought better in this fight, you know, because I thought they had to bring the best out of each other, and they had to bring different qualities out of each other. I think Golovkin coming forward so much in the first fight made Canelo realize, you know, I have to hold my ground a little bit better. And he brought the best out of Canelo in that he was holding his ground better. Do I think he should have been a little busier and used his jab more? Yeah, I think that's why he ultimately lost the fight anyway, you know. But I think still he realized he had to make an adjustment, and it brought better qualities out of him in that way. And Golovkin too, and Canelo making that adjustment, Golovkin had to make an adjustment back to him, you know. And I thought he did well in doing that, because he circled the ring and boxed well. He never wound up against the ropes, you know. So Golovkin, you didn't know, had this dimension to him, you know, because a guy who boxes going backwards and never touches the ropes, that's called boxing, and it's called boxing like classical boxing, you know what I'm saying? Like, you're boxing like right to the textbook T, you know. So, you know, I thought he did very well in showing that wrinkle to his style as well. So both guys showed different wrinkles from the first fight, and I think credit to both of them, but I think Golovkin was a more complete fighter.
He got the win, right? So it's going to go on the record as a win. Do you think Canelo's now pound for pound at the top?
Hey, listen, Canelo belongs to pound for pound. This is one of the best fighters in the world. I don't think he's at the top. I would probably rate guys like Vasyl Lomachenko, or even Terence Crawford, who's been in quite a few weight classes as well. You know, I would rate guys like that ahead of him, you know. But I think Canelo is in the conversation. I think Canelo is in the mix for the conversation. I don't think he's number one, but I think you put him in the conversation. This is a pretty good weight class, you know. Golovkin and Canelo seem to be the most popular guys, and so you make this fight. But, you know, you have guys like Demetrius Andrade and Billy Joe Saunders fighting. Those are very good fighters. Jamal Charlo is a monster.
I'm hearing he's fighting Willie Monroe.
Is he? Whatever it is. Regardless, you know, Willie Monroe is a slick guy himself, you know, who puts you to the test. But Jamal Charlo right now will say a monster, you know. And you know, there's these guys, you know, there's a lot of intermixing and matching that you have possibilities to make good fights. We'll see.